Now, sir, coming to the general approach, the financial and monetary approach, the finance minister, as in this budget and in the previous one also, adopted an approach of collecting real resources outside the budget and outside the finance bill. Last year, about 3,000 crores were collected on account of price rise, and this year, with the rise in the prices of petroleum and steel and coal, about rupees 1500 crores have been collected outside the budget, again on account of the increase in prices of steel and coal. Another rupees 500 crores would be collected. Technically, you can say that this is not a budgetary measures, but if they suffer a loss, these things will have to be taken into account. And to that extent, the budget deficit would have increased. Now, the state is playing the massive role, not merely in so far as maintenance of law and order is concerned, but also in so far as development activities are concerned. The old concept of collection of resources by way of taxation is there, and there is the injudicious method by which the government gets rupees 200 crores by taxing the petroleum product. Sir, last year the finance minister collected about rupees 200 crores on petrol and petroleum product alone on account of the rise in their prices. But now, if the method of resources mobilization increasing is through taxation, then I think it is necessary to ensure that this artificial distinct between resource mobilization through price rise and taxation would not stand in the by way of parliament, and the nation should be presented with a clear picture of what resources are being mobilized either through price rise or through taxation. This artificial destruction of saying that this price rise is no longer very realistic in the present day circumstances, because this price the central exchequer would have to pay for it, and it would be reflected in the deficit. Para. Sir, the method which has been adopted this year has mean that the resources had been collected outside the budget and parliament. The total burden that the people have to bear should be presented to the people clearly. It should be told that this is the price rise, this is the taxation increase, so that there is a real discussion on that. If this trend continues, then the budget and the finance bill will not become a major event in the economic policy of the nation. It will ultimately become a non-event. Therefore, some reorientation of the approach is necessary with regard to this matter. The resources released through price rise should be discussed in Parliament, and the entire picture of the budget should explain the entire thing. The modern economics as it is developing must be placed before the nation, and parliamentary discussion should take place. Otherwise, we are discussing only about rupees 200 crores taxes imposed by the central government on the people of this country.